All right, first things first, we got Adrian Broner. He just went crazy on Throwback Thursday on Instagram, and he just has a lot of kids. I just find this picture funny. Adrian Broner has a lot of kids. And this is a throwback. He actually has two more kids since then. And shout-outs to AB, man, taking care of all his kids, man, doing his thing. Shout-outs to my guy, Ellie Sekback. We got 400 million views. Team ES News, you know, shout-outs to Snow Queen, Villainfy. You know, Juan, we doing it, and I'm probably maybe responsible for about 3 million of those. So, man, we just going straight to the top, man. We're almost on 200,000 subscribers, and big shout-outs to Ellie Sekback. Bringing you the boxing news. Reporting. Drake, Champagne Poppy, he gave a really dope shout-out to Shakur Stevenson, man. Gave him a shout-out on Instagram, and he basically shouted out Andre Ward because Ward was wearing Drake sneakers, and Shakur Stevenson just like signed the management deal, I think, with James Prince and Andre Ward. So shout out to Shakur also. He's about to find his promo team and, you know, get on his professional career. This was really fun news. A little bit outside of the boxing world, but Conor McGregor is gonna star in Game of Thrones, according to Dana White. And yeah, so expect to see your favorite, you know, Irishman doing his thing in Game of Thrones. In the same interview that Dana revealed this to, we have him talking about him and 50 Cent at a restaurant in New York City. And 50 Cent is kind of like the catalyst here. He said that Floyd Mayweather is really interested in a fight with Conor McGregor, which kind of made Dana interested in it too. And he talked about it in this interview that you guys can check out. And who knows? We might see Floyd Mayweather, Conor McGregor. Could be. It's getting a little bit more realistic. I found this picture really funny. You guys can check it out. It's Sergey Kovalev is just still really sour and salty about his loss to Andre Ward. He called him the son of judges, which is just a hilarious nickname to call him because Andre Ward calls himself the son of God. And yeah, man, I really can't wait for this rematch. This is going to be good. There's a lot of bad blood between these guys. This video you guys can check out. It's kind of a sad story. Basically, this kid was getting like horribly bullied. And Roy Jones just, you know, sent out a really heartfelt video that you guys can check out. And, you know, maybe it helped that kid out because, you know, Roy's a boxing legend. And that kid just got really badly bullied. Check that out in the video right here.
Drew, what's happening, my man? How's it going? Look, I know life is hard right now, but, you know, God makes us and he builds us and builds us all for this race and this road that we have to walk. You have roads you have to travel. Sometimes that travel endures hard times. I've had to go through the same types of hard times. You just have to be strong and try your best to make it through these hard times, keeping God first.
Everybody, and I mean everybody, is jumping on the Conor McGregor train. Oscar De La Hoya came out. He said that the only real fight for Conor McGregor is Canelo at 160, which we all know was a huge big money fight. I mean, if it's not Floyd, Canelo's probably the guy that Conor McGregor could make the most money with. Plus, Canelo's a former Floyd opponent. It creates buildup. Never know. It's a good fight to look forward to. Obviously, we all know as boxing fans, Canelo absolutely obliterates him. Some other interesting developments in the middleweight division. We've got Triple G, Danny Jacobs. Big fight. The two by far biggest punchers at middleweight. The WBA, they're going to a purse bid now. I know Jacobs wanted a 60-40 split. Tom Loeffler isn't willing to go that high, but who knows? I hope this fight goes through. I hope Danny Jacobs doesn't. I hope he doesn't relinquish his belt because this is a really good fight to have at middleweight. It's honestly the only fight with two true middleweights at 160 to be had at middleweight. I mean, everybody wants a Triple G Canelo fight, but at middleweight, two guys who are proven at middleweight, Danny Jacobs and Triple G, is the best fight to make. Then I found this really interesting, man. I know I said on the last episode that Floyd was 50-0 with T.I., but now it really cements it. You've got Tiny, which is T.I.'s wife. She pretty much went on a tirade and, you know, admitted to everything with Floyd. She said, and her exact words were, "When a woman's fed up, for years I've been the one getting hurt. But now that a little video done surfaced with me having a friendly dance, he's mad? Why? Yes, he's my husband, but damn, can I not have a male friend? Floyd. Tip can't be the only male friend I associate myself with, just like I know I ain't the only female he associate himself with. So it is what it is. I mean, she has a point, but Floyd and T.I. already have beef. You're his wife. Floyd's the opposition. Like, what are you doing if you're T.I.'s wife? You're just giving... Long story short, Floyd's 50-0. T.I. just got obliterated right there. And yeah, man, Tiny is really... She's really a whack wife for that, honestly. In super duper duper sad news, Ed Brown, man, he was a promising welterweight prospect. He was 20-0, 16 KOs. He was shot and killed in Chicago recently, man. And that's really unfortunate because he was somebody that a lot of people were looking at. And, you know, outside of his professional career, I never got to meet him, but I've heard from a lot of my friends in the media that he was a really cool kid. So rest in peace, Ed Brown.